if you're traveling in British Columbia, in Mission City, in the Fraser Valley, on the east side of...
Thank you. visitors, if traveling in British Columbia, down in the Fraser Valley, we can find Mission, the small city, and from the tourist information booths about 2 miles east, we come to the place called Wagon Ward. Wagon Ward, it is a collection of historical wagons and carriages in miniature or in full size too. And about 100 of them, and that's 100 different kind, which is quite interesting to visiting. All what the people used, not only these two countries, but in Europe and in Australia as well.
Then I have to take your picture.
No, thank you. I just try to make a film.
Okay, I see. I see.
About what I have. And yes. First I put the sign on it. And
you're coming from Alberta? Which part of Alberta?
This time we come from northern Alberta.
Northern?
Yeah, but actually, you know,
I don't believe you haven't got a very heavy jacket on you, and I don't see snow on top of your head.
That's right. We're staying with some friends around, actually, here. And, you know, I had come last fall and mentioned...
Wagon Ward. What does it mean? It is a little collection of horse-drawn vehicle, wagons, carriages, what the people used before the first motor car was shown up on the road. We have about 100 over here, and which is an interesting thing, all 100 is 100 different type that the people use not only in these two countries, but in Europe or in Australia. They are not a toys, because I'm building them exactly 100% away how we building a full size. every small part what we can find on a full site, we can find it on these two. These are not made by machine, but I made them by with my hand in my little own shop. We can start here. This very first one is called a Red River cart. In the first day when the settlers, the immigrants came from Europe mostly in those years, they couldn't bring with themselves only just a few hand tools. And they found a section around in Red River or Winnipeg, and it was very hard to start to clear it. So with a simple axe, they tried to cut out wood branches or a tree or some, and without a piece of nail or a piece of wire, they just tied those wooden pieces together and made a cart. And the wheel, of course, wooden axle, wooden hub, wooden rim, but to hold it together, they covered it with raw buffalo hide. That raw hide was dried on, and that kept the wheel together. I heard a story. Section what they found, a new immigrant, it was covered not only with bush, but heavily it was covered with buffalo bones. Some farmer made a very first dollar to hauling buffalo bone to Winnipeg to grind it for fertilizer. The next one is the same thing that built a little bit fancier or smoother way, but exactly the same. And this was pulled by oxen. You see the yoke for the oxen. The next one is also the two-wheel cart, but this is English type, used in England. Very few years in England, they didn't use wagon, four-wheel wagon, only two-wheel cart mostly. But because it was very small, limited harvest they could put on. So in harvesting time, they hooked two together to make it longer. Here is a little young Holland boy pushing this two-wheel cart on a street in Holland and selling sardine, fish. Yeah. The little boy have even wooden shoes. The next one, also used in Holland, oh, you see, have a very wide wheel. Because this called boat wagon. It is shaped like a boat, and it is loose on a two axle. In Europe is very populated, overpopulated, and not enough land for the people. Then in Holland, they tried to grab land away from the ocean, loading up this little wagon with stone. And with the because the ocean is very shallow over there, the horses tried to pulling into the water until the load, until a body start to floating. Then they taking it wherever they want to flow, make a dike. Then after loading up with seaweed, putting on, pedaling on against a two axle, and the horses pulling it out because it is very good for fertilizer. The next one is a horse-drawn logging wagon. they used even to loading the wagon, the horses. So the horses had to not only to pull a wagon, but they had to help to load it up too. They put a rope around the extension pole underneath, again around a pole, a timber, and from another side, a horses roll it up slowly. Then they had to pull it. The next one, this is the Australian type stagecoach. It is different as a famous American Concord type. It is not round and all open, probably because of climate. And this was licensed for 17 people. You see the a brake, how it is moving. And the body moving on a swinging on a suspension belt. Okay, the next one is a doctor's wagon. Well, in those years, had no doctors, especially in a prairie, in every small town. So one man called himself doctor. This is Dr. Tadeusz Tripp, patent medicine. Well, of course, had no, maybe not even aspirin, or mostly just some kind of tea, some herb, or some liquid stuff. And that's how the people try to cure themselves, traveling from town to town and selling or just trading. The next one is called it beach wagon. Probably was carrying tourists around in a beach or in a town. The next one is a stagecoach. Well, this is not so fancy built as what they was using in the mainland, the Concord or even a Canadian, but because it was run between, in Alaska, between Valdez and Fairbanks. And every stagecoach was carrying not only passenger, but mail and parcel. And they hide the mail under the seat. Probably they had to dress it up very good in Alaska, because it had no cover on it. The next one, also the stagecoach, this was run in British Columbia, in Caribou, and the original, everybody can go to see it in 100 Mile House. It was run between Vancouver and Fort George, which is now Prince George. Also on the wall over here is hanging down, maybe not a very first bicycle, maybe a second one, because the very first one, they didn't pedal it. They just was sitting on, it was two wheel, same size, sitting on, and they just pushed themselves with their foot. Their foot was always on the ground, but it was fun anyway. This wagon, I should start it with around 1840-50 in British Columbia, only around 500 white people lived and had no transportation at all, only on horseback or on walking on trail or canoeing on a river. But after when they found a gold in Caribou and in Barkerville, then from San Francisco or from Los Angeles, slowly some 20,000 gold miners move up to Caribou, but had no any possibility to travel and to hauling all those food supply and miner supply. So one Frenchman, his name was Barnard, he established a wagon trail or between Vancouver and Williams Lake, I think once a week. That was the very first wagon transportation in British Columbia. The next wagon is, that's a show wagon, mostly big farmer using it. They used to paint their name on the side, what type farm they had, horse, beef, sheep, something. And with four or six horses, beautifully harnessed, they went to show or exhibition just for advertising themselves. The next wagon is that's a tour carriage. Today we have many tourists can afford to travel and like to see everything in a city. But from the running taxi, it hardly can see everything. So now mostly every big city, somebody operating the horse and carriage just for tourists. And how you see, every seat is a little bit elevated. So the tourist can see everything, everybody. The next one is, that's a mail carriage. It was used in the state. Mailman. The next one is called the next one is a buckboard. What is a buckboard? A buckboard is just a four wheel and have a flat floor on it. Some have some low side, some nothing. And they use the special plank or board, probably ash or something, which didn't break under the load, but springing a little. But to make it a little comfortable, they put spring, but only supporting a driver's side. Driver's seat, I mean. The next one is a widely used Canadian one-horse buggy, mostly used in the prairie, because the prairie people, they had wagon, but they wagon built for just hauling loose grain from the farm to the elevator. If they had to go to town, shopping or church or somewhere, they used the one-horse buggy. Some was built only just for two-person to get on. Some had a little place for storage behind the seat, and like this. We have over here some Amish carriage. Those people, because their faith and heritage, custom, they not using even today fancy carriages or wagon, but only one horse buggy and all same color and same style and all black. They refusing electricity or any modern fancy thing. The next one over here, this is also British Columbia used stagecoach. This was a very first stagecoach when those built the first road in Caribou and had to move a lot of people. So, but because the road condition was terrible and always was muddy, it was a stagecoach, but they called it simply mud wagon. The next one, we see this yellow color carriage over here. We rode on this carriage in a Yellowstone Park in a state. All carriages, how I mentioned it before, 100 but 100 different type. This is also built in different special way. This was used to taking tourists around in Yellowstone Park. Behind this, I have a peddler wagon. One man was drove with one horse and putting out everything what the people needed, and they couldn't buy it in a village store. Peddler. The next one, another again, is the flat wagon. Just for carrying something. The oxen wagon. Now over here, this wagon was used in Europe in the earliest year. Different with this wagon is almost all another type of carriages or wagon is the horses is hooked to the front, but on this one, I don't know the reason why, they hooked the horse to the rear axle. And have a weaker side, and how I seen it on the paper, what I find, it was used only for transportation. Here we have a pedal wheeler. Transportation movement in west around in British Columbia, it was started out in the country, only on river they could travel, canoeing or wherever a horse could walk in the water, or in a trail like these prospector with a probably heavily loaded donkey who are not able to carry his load or have a sore foot and don't want to go. When they found the gold around in 1850 in British Columbia, the Caribou and Barkerville, then they heard it in California where had a big gold rush, and slowly some 20,000 miners moved up to BC. But they could travel only, they could come up with a pedal wheeler from San Francisco and only up to Yale, because from Yale between Williams Lake or river is not navigational. So from there they just was walking or with a canoe or until Mr. Barnard was established his wagon trip to between Vancouver and Yale or San, I don't know where that, only once in a week first, later on twice in a week. A few settlers also moved to Caribou, not only just for gold prospecting, but to be a farmer. And because had no road, so they settled down both sides of the river, because it was the only possibility to able to move further up to Fort George was start to growing up, because Northwest Railway was starting to build up, and a lot of people went over there for working, get a job, and they needed food supply. So these people lived on the riverside. They was growing something or keeping some animal, and it was very easy on the river to take it to the market. A boat was operating, so they want to stop the boat to go to Prince George, then they just have to post a white flag on the pole. Then a captain know they want to get on. So they turn out the boat, and even they stop the boat if a farm lady had only just a gallon of milk or a couple dozen of eggs or a chicken to send it to Fort George. That was a style of living in those years. This is a horse-drawn ambulance. It was used in Vancouver, a first ambulance in Vancouver in 1902. Police force was operating it. They had a stable on Pender Street. And this is built exactly the way how the original. You can see have a sick man on a stretcher and a nurse standing by. And every carriage, every wagon have a story or a history. This, you have a, here are original stories. It said, once they was calling to a Granville and a Hastings, and the ambulance took 15 minutes to reach the scene. That no sooner had the injured man been loaded into the wagon, however, than one of the horses fell down. Before long, both horses were on the ground, and no amount of coaxing would move them. The horses were unhitched, but still refused to budge. Finally, a dozen of young men pushed and pulled the ambulance to the hospital. Once one lady had an operation in the hospital, after the operation, they was asking her, and despite the not a very good anesthetic system we had in those years, she told the operation wasn't so painful as to travel on this ambulance, because it had no spring on it, had no rubber tire, and in those years Vancouver Street was covered with a big bumpy cobblestone. The next one over here is called a hearse. Have a little coffin in, and we have two. But because Justic never had, you know, so it wouldn't be a fair thing, boat, hearse, because men dying too, so one should be his. No, boat or hearse. The next one is a famous police paddy wagon called Black Moriah. I had a visitor, the older man. He remembered he was a very young kid, and his daddy was serving in the police force in Vancouver. And somebody was reporting a problem to him, and he gave a loud order called a Moriah. The next one, also the police, but this is for emergency. The next one is an antique dealer buying, selling, what is it, is it a gramophone, a coffee grinder, a potbelly stove, thing like that. The next beside is an ice wagon. I remember myself, when an iceman came, they had a big loud bell hook on the horse, so everybody knew it well before it's coming. Then a lady called him to bring one bar up for me, and the man had a big piece of leather on his shoulder and a steel hook on his hand. He pulled off one bar from the wagon, about 8 by 8 by 3 feet long, put it on his shoulder, carry it up to the floor, second floor, or, and the lady was waiting with a wooden box, had a sawdust in or straw to stay longer, didn't melt so soon. That was a deep freeze, frigid air in those years. The next one over here, this is a mailman carriage. In a country, the farmer or a people used to mount the mailbox on a used farm implement, like on this plow. And you see the coffee pot on the rear end. This we found it in a Montana Museum, full size of course. That's why I have a US paint on it. And it was used in Coffee Creek, Montana. Right beside is a milk wagon. Some lady told she remembered in Burnaby, Vancouver, it was running in 42. Again, the lady told me this milkman was waited by many ladies warmly because he delivered not only milk, butter, or eggs, or bread, but if a husband was not home, then baby too, she told to me. The next one is bakery wagon. It said Tammy's Bakery, bread, buns, and pastry, telephone 101. So if you want to eat some delicious buns, call 101. The next one over here, this is a Australian type stagecoach, what I've shown before. This is a little bit larger. Right beside a school bus. School district number 28, Linden. That's where my granddaughter going to school. Young children coming over here with parents, and sometimes I asking, how you go to school? She said, "Mommy, take me," or with school bus. But they had no idea how funny it would be to go with horse-drawn school bus, especially in a prairie. Even winter time, they had only just a simple wooden box, had a sleigh underneath to go to school, and even had a little wood stove in it because of distance and because of terrible cold. That over here is a streetcar. Those here had no electricity, and they built a track in the center of the street, and a horse pulled it, usually one car. Some city was built on hillside, and the horse pulled it up to the end of the road, and they used to build this front platform over there a bit longer. Then they put the horse on it and simply just slide down freely, so the horse had a chance to rest too. The next one is called omnibus. Omni is a Latin word, they mean for everyone. Big company was operating it, and people could sit in a garden seat on the top too, and they could climb up on the top. We can see on the rear a curved stairway. Today we have the same thing. We're not calling it omnibus, but double decker. The next one beside, that's one man was operating it privately, small, only four or six people. That was a taxi. The entrance is from the rear. A most famous stagecoach, Concord, built in Concord by Stephen Lewis, Stephen Abbott and Lewis Downing. In 1822, and they was kept building it until 1915, and it was running up to almost in 1930. It's really nicely built, and everything is working. Brake system, and see, a body is suspended on two long piece of leather and moved on a rough road like a cradle. So riding on whole day, it didn't make the people tired, rather sleepy. And traveling all day, shaking up the person, you know, a liquid in them, they had to stop to relieve themselves. For that reason, they kept the bedpan under the seat for a lady. A canvas raincoat for a man, if they had to, and they handed it to them, they had to walk away, cover them, do it, and after they could go another half day. The stagecoach has many stories, legends, and the stagecoach was an aristocrat on the road. Every other yielded to them. Big company was hiring only the best, strongest man who was able to handle 4 or 6 horses and keep the coach on the rough road and keep the time between point to point. Able to deal with stagecoach rubber, there was a magic in the calling of a stage driver. Many little boy had a dream to become a stage driver. They was glorified men, just like today the astronaut. These modern day, if stagecoach would run, because the traveler not carrying gold with them, the would be hold up men probably would accept not only dollar bill, but Visa card, MasterCard, or maybe even Safeway coupon too. The little grain grinder, some type of animal, presently is too little donkey, going round and round, turning that big heavy stone wheel, and on that platform they used to put the wheat or the corn to grind it. Then grandma could make a good whole wheat bread. How I told, this is not only a simple collection, but a little bit of history too. Transportation history. Here is a very first train in the US. How you see it, three stagecoach put hooked together, but instead of wooden wheel, they put steel wheel under. And the government ordered this funny looking engine from England. It's called John Bull. And it was, see, it is moving like a stagecoach. Because in those years had no factory to turn out rail car like we have today. So they was hiring Mr. Abbott, who built a stagecoach. Then he built stagecoach too. And it was built between 1828. And the first ride, it was free who dared for. Because many people didn't see train or never traveled on train yet, and they afraid, they get scared. Probably even didn't run more than faster as 20 miles an hour. This is a smaller stagecoach, not completely painted yet. Another one in the corner over here is called Gospel Wagon. The preacher is missing yet, and the stairway. When those people move from Europe, from different country, but they had a fate with them, and they couldn't find a church over here to build a simple sod house. That was a first priority, not to build a church yet. So one man who don't want to farming, it was an easier life, built or bought a wagon, and with one horse he was traveling to small houses or settlement to another, and calling people and preaching the Bible and collecting the money. How I said, history of transportation. Look at this royal lady over here. This horse-drawn litter carried Isabelle Bourbon from French to her bedroom hall in England in 1400. And even she had no Honda car to go, or Toyota, but you see that gondola or cab, it was hooked on, supported by two horses. And that's how they was walking and carry her. Even in 15th, 16th century in England, people could travel only just walking, or rich men offered to king or pope was traveling in that way too. And here is a paper, it said the Chinese invented a wheel, and somehow, a wheelbarrow, and somehow the wheel found itself to England, then they put that wheel under this walking chair. After they called it rolling chair and needed only one man to pull it. But probably because of climate in England, they built a little cab on it. And that's a way how it's find its way back to China, where they still using it today as a rickshaw. But camelback. But they built carriage because just like today, a new technology is going first to use in the army. So even those years, they built a carriage, but not for a simple people, but for the army, and they called it chariot. Another two-wheel car over there was used in England, Roseland Dairies. Big container front of the driver, and the lady was waiting for him with the own container. A man had to reach in and, well, 1 liter for you, 1 liter for you, and that's how they get the milk supply. Also had not only milk cart, but butcher cart also. Over here we have a covered wagon. This wagon again have a story. A lot of people traveled in the beginning, able to stay in for a short time until they reach the destination. This wagon, many settlers used it in these two countries. In America, a free land pulled a people from Europe, where not enough land for a people, so they moved over every year by year. But slowly, the eastern part of the state was taken up. So the latecomer, they had a chance only to come to west. So when they arrived, landed in the New York area, they had to build or buy a covered wagon and put everything on what they needed to start a new life. On one side have a plow, on the other side a water barrel, and this is a family, and they put together a wagon train, 50s or even 80 covered wagon, and they made a wagon train, but had only one track, so it was mile and mile long. And it took 6 months to come across a country from east to west, to take the land away from the Indian. And on the road, of course, the roadside had no grocery store, and in the wagon had no frigidaire to store food. What they could eat, they was supplemented what they able to shoot, hunting or fishing, and many of them died on the road by hunger, by sickness. And sometime when they stop for night time to resting, Indian charged them, robbed them, some was even massacred, until they reached the promised land in Oregon just before winter. That's little two-wheel cart of this little two-wheel cart is Mormon people used it when they had to move from east to west. Not every family had a wagon and to put up their belongings. Some family had only just a two-wheel cart, and daddy pushed it and pulled it, and mommy pushed it. They put their belongings on. And this little carriage is now put up in a temple yard in Salt Lake City for a reminder how hardship they had. Next one over here is a plowman. You see how he's blowing up his, breaking up his land. Many older people was visiting here, and some told when they was breaking up their land, they had two children. The land was covered with bush and tall grass, and so much mosquito, they drive the horse crazy. So even a little 5-6-year-old kids, they had to walk on both sides of the horses with the tree branches or some piece of rag on a pole, and try to drive away a mosquito from the horses so they would not run away. How hard it was for the children, little children, to walk all day on that uneven land in a tall grass. How many times they fell over. They had no chance to play football or baseball like this today kids. Here, let me show one picture over here. This is showing the Dukabur people when they arrived to this country. Also, they was poor, had no animal to pull a plow, so they hook up grandma. See, the man was smarter in those years too. He just holding up the plow. That could be used to today lady to lose weight instead of using those expensive machine to try to get rid of the bacon. In those years, a farmer had to build their own farm tools, like this. That's a harrow. One man told, oh, we used it for many purposes, not only just to smoothing up the land, but winter time we turn it over and went to a bush to put a timber on it. That's a roller. Two horses was pulling it. The next one over here, again, this is another buckboard. You see, this is only just a flat bottom, and how I told before, where it got the name from England, where a goat used to jump on a buckboard, have a spring only under the seat, just to support the driver seat. The next one, over here we have on the shelves, is a Cinderella carriage. Cinderella, poor little girl, go to the ball, find a princess, and lost, find a prince and lost him too. But she willingly or not left her shoes behind so the prince could track her down. Another one is a grain wagon used on the prairie with a simple lever to move. They could drop the bottom completely and in a minute the grain was thrown out. Next one is a light delivery wagon in a city. Very nicely built, original. The next one is a hay wagon used on the farm, only haying time. Next one over here, that green one with a team of white oxen, this is the Hungarian simple farm wagon, but that people use the wagon not only like a Canadian, one for hauling loose grain, another one, because the Canadian, if they went to a town or church or marketplace, then they used a one-horse buggy. But those people used it for everything. In Europe, all the houses built of solid stone wall, 20 inch wide, they had to go on a rough road to the mountain and hauling stone far away. And that was a very heavy load. So that's why what you can see over here is a supporter of the side sitting on the end of the axle and holding a wagon side. Also, they used to put seat on. It's very simple to put 2-3 seat on and lift it up in a second, because they used it go to a marketplace, go to a church, to the doctor, or even decorated it and went to a wedding party. So they built a step on it. Easy to get on and off, what you can find on a Canadian style wagon. Inside over there, that's an English type carriage, Brougham. Some rich men didn't like no one type of carriages, so this rich man drawing one for himself, give it to a master, and they build it for, especially for him, after they built many. But it's very practical, and they called it after his name, Brougham. That's again a Canadian one-horse buggy. Next is a fringe top surrey. Without a top, they called it only Democrat. We have a very nicely built little carriage over here as really very nice style. This was built in Germany. The German prince was married a Swedish princess. Húzd ide ki a büdös frázban ezt a drótokat. The next one over here called Hansom Cab. You see the driver is sitting high above behind the cab. So the passenger have a privacy. Right beside a next one is called bridal carriage. That's really nicely built again. I'm building them, my wife painting and finishing the upholstery and putting some passenger in it. In this one, the bride going to the wedding. Next one beside, I built a full size that is running in Vancouver. It's called Vis-a-Vis. And using it, the owner using it mostly for wedding. See the good looking bride on with the flower girl. And see the groom is very lucky with his bride because he getting a little bonus with the bride. In that little basket, almost look like Moses was put down in a water in a Nile. A surprise, probably. The next one, this is a wedding cart also, but this is for a poor girl, a poor bride. See? They are sitting even only on a straw. It's a very poorly built carriage or cart. They could not afford a same as a rich bride. The next one behind over here is a German type Landau. It's like a convertible. Like a convertible. Yeah. Another one is a Hungarian style. We called it Sandrunner, because the rich landowner used to use it to go out to the field to checking the crop or the workers, how they are working. So always was running on the sandy road, so we called it Sandrunner. The next one behind over here, that's a really a nicely built two-wheel cart. And beside another vis-a-vis without a bride. Next one over here, I told before, not only a little collection this, but a little bit of history of transportation. This black carriage over here, this was built to and used by Napoleon. And I found an old magazine and I was able to build one. It said, after Napoleon, they put everything in a museum in Paris, but the museum burned down, including this carriage too. This, again, European style carriage. It was not used in this country. This blue one over here, that's a coach. What is a coach? A coach which is closed in, which is open, it is a carriage. The coach, the name, it was originated according the history book, doesn't matter in which country the book was edited, published, all is recognizing the coach was built in Hungary, originated from Hungary, a place it was named Coach, Coach Village. That's another. And this one over here, that's called Victoria. Have a second seat on. In the corner over here, we can see a few covered wagon. This is a famous Conestoga wagon. And before they built a railway in western part of California, this type of heavy built wagon was carrying all the supply from east to west. Very often 5 tons they put on, and 4-6 horses was pulling it. The army used it in a civil war too. That's why we tried to make a little army camp over here, have a Red Cross first aid wagon and a few soldiers over here, and the army kitchen. The army kitchen horse pulled it, and you know, they had to carry their own firewood under the seat because they couldn't find dry wood. They had to cook even when they was running back or forth. In this corner, we can see some Indian camp. Well, really, this not belong to a transportation. But they had no any wagon or carriage that they didn't use. But they used to put, they had to move sometime, but they used to put only 2 wooden branch crossing on the horse back and put a blanket on and that's sit on or lay on. That's how they was traveling. Right over here have a gypsy caravan wagon. With one horse, the gypsy was traveling from place to place to country to country, because they not recognizing government or country border. They freedom lover people and they claim the whole world belonged to them. They not used to carry identification, and so they are home where they stop for resting. That's a fire brigade, voluntary fire brigade, Dudney. The horses was pulled it, and sometime the dog was running front of them to show where is a fire. And, leather wagon. and water tank. And this black carriage is for prisoner. This is a chuck wagon. Shepherd who have to stay out with a flock all year, they had to have their own supply with them, and this was a table and a kitchen. The next one over here is a famous Russian troika. In Russia, many parts have snow through and the whole year, so they can travel only with sleigh. And in that area have a lot of wolf, probably tiger too, which are used to jump on not only a passenger, but on the horses too. And see, for that reason, a two-side horse, the head is turned out, because if the horses can see the jumping wolf, then they can kick or bite the wolf. And story say, if they are too far from home, they stuck in a snowstorm, and too many wolf coming and run out of bullet, then they used to unhook one horse and turn it to them and try to run, save their life. The next one over here is a Viking wagon. The Viking people was here even 500 years before Columbus was. This carriage or wagon was discovered in a cemetery place where they found a Viking boat. This was buried with a boat together. And it was in the 9th century where in Europe or other places, they were starting to use wagon in the 15th, 16th century. But they built one in the 9th century. They found it in Osberg, so in Norwegian, so they called it Osberg wagon. The another one is over here. Budweiser wagon. The next one, this is a earliest wagon before they were starting to use spring. So this is a way how they suspended it on chain. The next one beside, this is the first foggy. Before we had a the wagon, I mean a car to collect money, this was the first travel bank to take money to distributing it or collecting it. In the very corner we have some sleigh over here. One-seater. Yeah. On the wall over here you can see the oxen yoke. A little bit foggy over here. And also a few wheels, larger, smaller, just for. On this side, I try to build a little collection of circus wagon for the children. Circus come to town. These fancy circus wagon is now not operating. All is in the circus museum. I used to say to the young children coming over here, we are not allowed any longer to put the animal in cage, only bad boy. They used to laugh. We still working. Here we have a few wheel, a different type of that's a flat tire, looks like a flat tire. Another is not quite a wheel. The next one is a square wheel. Probably this was the very first to try it. And that's a out of center. Another one is like a, working like a old man wheel. Our wheel is not perfect now after 60 years. That's again another one, and that looks like pretty good. And a pedal wheel. And the next one, that's a railroad wheel. And beside that red one is a pedal wheel. And here is also some over here. I was asking one man what you think, what these are. He said, it is showing how to make a wheel. I said, exactly the opposite. How not to make. Just for fun. Here you can see the knife grinder. One man had to push it from street to street and call the lady to bring the knife and a knife and a scissor to sharpen it. The life was different as before. If something gets sharp, simply just throw it away. Cut down again.